The following program may contain language of an adult nature. Listener discretion is advised.
Views and opinions expressed on the following program are those of the hosts and guests, and not necessarily those of the staff or management of AllTalkRadio.net.
We think it's the banning of speech.
Are First Amendment protection material. And if you don't know, you better ask somebody. My boy Maxwell Silverhammer and my bottom bitch jerk man will set you straight with some good old true shit and none of that shit that irks me. Hey Maxie baby, I still got them videos. You fill my serial port perfectly, bitch.
Yes! Finally kicked those fuckers off the air!
It's about goddamn time I got sick of those fucks!
Yeah, that G.J. Jerkman and Maxwell Silverhammer with all their goddamn anti-corporate talk.
Just be happy. We're gonna go celebrate right now. I think we should go do some golf and buttfuck one another.
Oh, that's the greatest! I'm ready. Hold on. Go get in the car here.
Get the hell out of the other side. Another side. There we go.
There we go.
All right.
This is a great day.
I'm going to start it up now. You ready?
These bastards.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Bora Bora, here we go.
It's the Still Radio Show.
Maxwell Silverhammer, G.J. Jerkman, Cruise Control, and G. Motor. Do you smell fire? I think somebody lit a cigarette. No, it's the hottest radio show on the internet. So keep it locked here from 7 to 9. Cause the STEM radio fam, they ahead of their time. And that was lesson one, man. This is lesson two. No format because they keep it fresh and new. And this is what I call HQ. A whip, musical genius, man. They can't paint it like a basic. But if the content is making you sick, take some fake whip. And if you think that the jocks sound quirky, allow me to introduce you to the shit.
Welcome to the Monday edition of STEM Radio, where the man behind the mic believes everybody should get a masturbation tax rebate, Maxwell Silverhammer.
Yes, bitches. Yeah, they should. You know what? If I had a tax rebate for all the times I masturbated, I'd be a rich man. Sorry, I'm adjusting my mic here. It's having some impotency issues. Well, next to me here in the studio is... former assemblyman Lou Tooman. What's going on, Lou?
Not much. This is quite a setup you have here, Brett.
I'm
absolutely amazed, actually. Well, I'll probably never get invited back to another radio show, but what the fuck?
Hey, man, that's what it's all about, right?
Yeah, it seems that way. when in Rome, you know.
Exactly. When in Rome, piss on the flowers, right?
Well, at least.
Something. Are there flowers in Rome? I guess there are somewhere.
God, there's flowers everywhere. Even in Las Vegas in the desert, there's flowers.
Yeah, that's true. We have our own kind of flowers.
Yes.
So, man, give us your credentials real quick.
Oh,
just,
God.
Just kind of a little
how long,
short.
How late? How many hours does the show go here?
We only got 2 hours, man. But, you know.
Well, I've been in town 45 years now or thereabouts, and... Actually, I came here when it was still a nice place. Corporate wasn't
ass-ramming everybody.
Ripping everybody off. And you could get a lot of free dinners at the hotels, you know, which are unheard of anymore.
Oh, God, yeah.
In any event, I found a lady that I went with and ended up getting married. Mary, I don't know if you remember her or not.
Think so.
And I was managing the Las Vegas Sporting House where we met.
Yeah, right.
Back then, and of course it now is one of the I think it is the largest titty bar in the world, actually, called
Is it really?
Yeah, in fact I can't even remember the name of it right now, but it that's what it morphed into.
So it's not a health club anymore.
No, it's not. My God, it hasn't been for about 10 years now, I think.
Wow.
Yeah, it's Sapphire Gentlemen's Club is what it's called.
Oh, that's Sapphire?
Yes, that's the Las Vegas Sporting House.
Shit, okay, yeah, because I've heard of it. You know, titty bars are not really my kind of place. When you don't see, you know, it's kind of pointless. And I know my friends...
Well, you should have the option of touching, you know.
You don't, you're right.
And, absolutely.
But here's the bitch. I remember one time I went with a friend of mine to, I think it was Little Darlings or one of those places. And we're in there, and of course, you know, they're calling out the girls' names. No, here comes Deborah Deeptwat, or whatever the whatever her name was. And, you know, they have her come out, and she's doing her thing, and the music's playing. I'm like, this shit sucks because, you know, I can't see what's going on. So I'm telling my buddies, I'm like, guys, I'm not getting much out of this. So then they're like, well, tell you what, hold on. And the guy knew that my friend knew the DJ, so he goes up to the DJ and tells him it's my birthday, which it wasn't. But so the guy comes, you know, he says, tell you what, for your birthday, we're going to have him to give you a little lap dance. And I'm like, oh, okay, that's cool. So they have me come on stage, and, you know, then they tell me, you got to sit on your hands. And I'm like, huh? And they're like, yeah, you got to sit on your hands. So the girls come up and they're rubbing their tits on me. And, you know, one girl straddling my waist. And I'm just like, well, this sucks, man. This is like, you know.
Well, you didn't obey them, did you?
Don't tell me you did. Should have. Yeah, well, you know, I didn't want to get arrested or something. Because they will arrest your ass, won't they?
I don't know. I've never been in one, believe it or not.
Really?
Honest to God.
That's probably a good idea.
Actually, I lied. Wait a minute. I had the guy that bought Sapphire, or the guy that bought the Sporting House and turned it into Sapphire's, invited me there on opening night, just because he knew I managed the place, and he wanted me to see what it looked like, you know. And I went in and I walked around and I looked, and the transformation was so bad, I mean, from what we knew it as,
right,
that I walked out. But that was my only time that I'd ever been in.
I mean, there was a second story to the place, so what did they do to that? Is that where they, like, if guys pay extra, they can go up there? And
those are where all of those where you watch the racquetball games from up above, those are all private rooms now, private lap dances take place.
So they can get, new guys can get their dicks
sucked. Then, I'll try to describe this for you, from that level, there was a ramp that went halfway down from there to the basketball court, and then there was a big platform, and the girls came from up at that second story, walked down that ramp, got on that platform, started taking stuff off, and then walked down steps to the where the basketball court was.
Oh.
That was the whole thing.
Wow.
Yeah.
What a setup, man. That's
I felt really bad. Because we knew it as a different place, and what they did to it, I was just upset. So.
Well, and see, that's the thing, man. It just seems like a lot of people are moving here from out of town, you know, like we said, the corporate types, and they're changing it, you know, into what they think Vegas is, you know, which, yeah, you know, okay, we're Sin City or whatever, but there was still a respectable element, wouldn't you say?
Well, I don't know, because my understanding is that most of the people that are moving here are illegal.
Well, there you go.
And they don't have IDs, so they can't go into that place because they couldn't prove how old they were. You know?
Oh.
So I don't know.
Well, we're becoming a mini, we're like a mini Los Angeles now. My buddy calls it white trash L.A.,
Well, I wouldn't argue with that. It's getting to be that way.
Yeah, well, I mean, like you said, you got the illegals, but you got all the white trash that comes in, and they think they're going to change things and, you know, turn it around and you know, like, okay, the smut peddlers. They weren't out there then, were they, back then?
You know, I don't – you're talking about the people on the sidewalk that are hustling those magazines and whatnot.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't remember them, Brett. Not like it is. I was actually walking up on the strip about 2 weeks ago with a friend of mine, and about every five steps somebody accosted you and shoved, you know, literature in your hand.
Right.
It was really – I didn't care for it at all. It was not what I'm used to.
That's what I'm saying. That wasn't traditional Vegas we knew.
Absolutely not.
Wow. Man.
Anyway.
Well, so yeah, you've been, you ran the Sporting House. You're...
Well, from there, and it was in 1990. I lived down off of Flamingo and Eastern, where I do now, as a matter of fact. And I kept calling my county commissioner because I couldn't get anything in the neighborhood. The lights didn't work. There were potholes in the street. And she'd never return a phone call.
Oh, that's typical.
And her name was Karen Hayes, and she was a two-time incumbent commissioner in my district, in our district now. And anyway, she'd never return a phone call. And I said, I'll fix her. I'm going to run for her seat. And she came up for election in 1990, and I ran against her as a Democrat. And she beat me, but only by 200 and some odd votes. And that gave me the bug.
So from there,
bug, because I was apolitical prior to that.
Well, you know, I'm pretty apolitical myself, especially, you know, the whole political climate. I'm totally disenchanted with, because
I was disenchanted a different way than we are now. I was disenchanted because my representative wouldn't contact me and ask me what was wrong. You know.
Well, this is what's funny, though. I mean, you see these people now, you know, especially at events and whatever. And boy, when they want those votes, they're standing, you know, like that Seniors United meeting I've told you about.
Yes.
You know,
I belong to that.
And when you go there, every time, these guys are like cockroaches, man. They're standing there. Hi, how you doing? My name is Gerald Jizzlebag. I want your vote on, you know, November. And you're going, yeah, great. And then all of a sudden, you know, the guy gets in office and does what your woman just did. Where,
well, the perfect example of that is our governor of the state. And you know, I loved him at one time, but he promised when he ran that he would never raise taxes. He promised it. I mean, he promised it on TV and the papers everywhere. And what did he do? He went ahead and raised, you know, $1 billion worth of taxes. That's a lie.
Well,
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And that typically points out politicians because they all promise and never deliver.
Well, that's the problem, you know, and that's why I've gotten very disenchanted with, you know, I mean, that's the whole reason, you know, I've gotten to the point now, I don't even vote anymore.
Well, that's, I would admonish you for that. I think you should vote.
Really?
I think everybody should vote. It's a way of exercising your right.
Does a vote really even matter anymore?
Not necessarily, but the point is that you're doing something
do
that
it?
You should be doing something. You know, everybody should vote. Not that it matters, but you should vote.
Well, that's ridiculous. That's like saying, well, you know, if you know, you pull your penis out, you know, you may get it sucked. Well, yeah, but
wait, what do you mean may? In this town, you will.
Well, it depends on where you are.
Well, I think it's getting to be no matter where you are.
I mean,
and it doesn't matter who either.
Really? Well, I could be at home. Yeah.
But that's a story for another day.
Well, you know, that's just funny though. Yeah, because it's to me, it just seems like, well, people are being asked to leave their work to go. Really, I just see it as a way of them. They can track you through a vote. That's it.
Well, the people that are asked to go, you know, don't really have to go. But worse than that, the unions in this town make their members go.
See,
they hand them a marked ballot, drive them to the poll if necessary, make sure they cast their vote, or otherwise they do not have a job the next day.
Here's what the thing about that is, too, and I've heard about this with unions. Unions will actually make you take a particular candidate and vote for them. You know what I'm saying? Like, they want you to vote for that candidate.
They mark the ballot. That's right. That's exactly what they do.
Wow.
And not only that, there's a big thing going on right now about a union membership dues that the leadership goes ahead and takes that money and donates it to whom they want to with regards to candidates, whereas the membership, the rank and file, has no say-so as to where it goes.
So the ones who are paying those dues don't have a say-so as to where the money goes.
No, and they really don't have a say-so as far as the leadership and the organization of the unions either. All they are are worker bees, basically.
Wow. So you're paying to have somebody tell you, basically, it's like having an HOA. You're paying them to dictate your life, pretty much.
Yeah, that's true. And if you got, you know, five or six Nazis on that board, you ain't going to get diddly squat.
Well, I know, you know, I used to date somebody who was with the RTC. And, you know, it sounds like the union didn't do shit.
Did she drive a bus?
No, actually, she did. She was a call taker. So when you called to set up your rides,
yes,
that's who that was,
uh-huh.
One of those people. So, but I mean, she would always tell me, oh, you know, they're never doing shit for me. I got to meet with this union representative.
It's all true.
And they call. God, so I guess when they say right to work, that means you don't have to join the union, is that?
Well, yeah, but they actually do because let's face it, try to get a job. If you were a female as a cocktail waitress in a hotel, almost impossible anymore.
Right.
Even the stagehands union, if you're not a member of that, it's very difficult to go to work in a showroom in a hotel.
So your average chick, even if she's hot, right, applies for a job as a, you know, cocktail waitress. If she's not part of the union, she's not going to get in?
That's exactly right.
Wow. Politics, man. See, this is the shit I don't like, man.
Well, it gets worse than that, Brett, actually. I think we discussed this the other day. I just finished last year my 13th consecutive election. I run every 2 years. I did get elected. I lost in 90, but I got elected in 92 to the state legislature as assemblyman and went to Carson City, where I was told by the leadership, if I didn't do as I was told, that I would not be more than a one-termer. And of course, you know how my mouth is. I didn't take that very well, and I did as I wanted to do. And of course, I've never been able to get reelected or ever get a penny's worth of donations because of it.
Wow.
But so, I just do it every 2 years now. I know I'll probably never get elected, but I will do it to rub their noses in it. And incidentally, I was the highest freshman legislator of that session.
Wow.
So that really, you know, kind of amplifies the point.
So obviously, you see, this is what shows you, again, that the vote doesn't count. You got people that want you in there, but they're not letting you in.
That's true. It's like a fraternity and sorority, man. It is. It's just
wow. And it shouldn't be, man, because you know what? Those people work for us.
Well, they don't seem to know that, though, Brett. That's the problem. You know it, and I know it.
Right.
But they don't know it.
This is the shit we talk about all the time on here. You know, well, and it's just totally, you're just completely emphasizing.
Can you imagine how much worse it would be if nobody voted?
Well, you know what?
I mean, it would be worse than ever.
I'm wondering, though, what if no one voted?
Well, let's see. Realistically, if nobody voted, then there wouldn't be any elections.
Well, there you go.
Maybe that would be the best answer.
You know, that's what I'm saying. I mean, what can you do at that point? I mean, it's not yet a dictatorship, but it's trying to go there.
Yes.
know that.
In that direction it's headed, yes.
So, you know, I guess I can see where your point is of, hey, man, exercise your right. You have that right to vote, whatever. But if that vote means nothing, you know.
Well, you know what it does, though? If you vote, then you can argue with somebody about something, an issue. Whereas if you don't vote on that particular issue, you have no right to argue about it.
Well, then again, I always say if you voted, you can't bitch. Like, you obviously allowed it to happen, so.
But you can bitch. I mean, if you voted and it went the other way, certainly you could bitch.
Well, it's kind of like, I always joke with this, it's, you know, like, yeah, you have these rights, you don't necessarily use them. I mean, like gun rights. You know, not everybody owns a gun. But, you know, what do you tell them?
But that's their problem, isn't it?
Well, yeah.
I own one or two or three or four.
Well, and I own a gun myself.
Well,
but
that's their fault. They don't want to own a gun. They feel it's dangerous. They certainly can own one if they
sure.
want to.
Right. Well, that's how I feel about voting. Or same thing if, you know, you might as well tell somebody, hey, you know you have the right to a fair and speedy trial. Why don't you go commit a crime? It's your right. Come on, man. Exercise that right.
Incidentally, speaking of guns, I was the guy that wrote the concealed weapons law in the state. It took me 6 months to gather all the information and put the bill together. And by the last day of the session in 93, we ran out of time. But the bill was already in place. And when they went back 2 years later, that bill was one of the first bills that got passed. But I call myself the architect of the concealed weapons law in the state of Nevada.
Oh, that's awesome. That's pretty. Have you, I know there's, because now that's a hot issue with the gun thing.
It seems to be our illustrious president wants to take everybody's guns away.
Yeah.
I can tell you it's a hot issue.
Well, that's, you know, step towards dictatorship. You know, if you don't have any guns, you can't defend yourself against the military, whatever they want to do. It's
well,
all on you.
See, Russia took the guns away. Iraq took the guns away. Look at all the countries that where the dictatorships confiscated the guns and they all went down.
Yeah. Well, and look at them now. Yeah. I mean,
that's the first thing that happens. You got to take weapons away from the citizens.
Wow. And
then they can't defend themselves against the government.
Hopefully that doesn't happen.
Well, you know, that's why the Second Amendment exists anyway. It's to defend yourself against the government. That's basically what it was put in place for.
Oh, I know. Yeah, see, and that's why they want to stop that.
Of course.
Because those are the criminals, man. Those are the ones you got to watch out for, obviously. Yeah. You know, not just, you know, crackheads trying to break into your house. You know, that's one thing, but.
There was a case, I think it was just last week. There's been several in the last couple of months, but just last week, a 16-year-old kid shot two home invaders. Killed
nice.
One And the other one, I think, was very seriously wounded, ended up in the hospital. 16-year-old kid.
Good deal. I'm like, good to hear.
And the media actually reported it as well, which was hard for me to believe. But,
wow. Hmm. Well, yeah, but maybe that's one of those things because there's an underlying tone of, look, a 16-year-old child had hold of a gun, you know.
Well, the father and mother were sleeping, and so was his sister.
Oh, yeah. No, so, I think it's great. But, you know, the gun of... Hip-hop bangers like... I'm in the building and I'm feeling myself. Rest in peace, Mac Dre. I'ma do it for the Bay, okay? Getting paid, we'll holler whenever that stop. My team good, we don't really need a mascot. Classic throwbacks, life. Well, I'm peeping and I'm creeping and I'm creeping. But I damn near got caught, cause my beeper kept beeping. Now it's time for me to make my impression felt. So sit back, relax, and strap on your seatbelt. You've never been on a ride like this before. Every Friday night at 9 o'clock Pacific Standard Time. And Saturday at midnight Eastern Standard Time. Only on the Tough Love Show on JNJ.FM.
Yee! What up, though? It's the undeniable JT Money, a.k.a. the Bitchizer. And you tuned in to STEM Radio with Maxwell Silverhammer and GJ the Jerk Man. Heavy that. And guess what? They hate hoes almost as much as I do. So don't sleep on these cats. And speaking of sleeping, don't forget to check out my new single, Hustlin', from my new project, Morning Wood. It's going down heavy, baby. And speaking of being out, I'm out like a busted traffic, like you already know. Get him, Jay!
At last, the wait's finally over. B-Sick returns from a long hiatus with a brand new album entitled Mr. Zero Tolerance.
Available for digital download only.
B-Sick's no-punches-pulled approach on the mic gives listeners what they want, as well as gives the rap game a well-deserved kick in the ass, with such hard-hitting gems as the title track, Mr. Zero Tolerance. Mr. Zero fucking tolerance, you think that you're fun. My tongue's replacing the gun, my toleration is nuts. Or the laid-back, fun-filled street anthem entitled Change of Pace, featuring Ghost.
This is something to bump as a gift to the haters, so turn it up loud just to piss off your neighbors. And if you out rolling, you be getting a ticket. And if you
straight to the guts, blind to the facts.
Blind to the facts that your mind's in a trap. Blind to the facts that with time we adapt. Blind to the facts of what you don't understand. Blind to the facts by the media scam. Blind to the facts of what you read in the book.
Download your copy today of Mr. Zero Tolerance from www.cdbaby.com or go to www.cdbaby.com/cd/bsick2. Download your copy today. Keep the realness in the rap game.
Yee! What up, though? It's the undeniable JT Money, a.k.a. the Bitchizer, and you tuned in to STEM Radio with Maxwell Silverhammer and GJ the Jerk Man. Heavy that. And guess what? They hate hoes almost as much as I do. So don't sleep on these cats. And speaking of sleeping, don't forget to check out my new single, Hustlin', from my new project, Morning Wood. It's going down heavy, baby. And speaking of being out, I'm out like a busted traffic, like you already know. Get him, Jay!
We think it's the banning of...
We are anonymous. And if you don't know, you better ask somebody. My boy Maxwell Silverhammer and my bottom bitch Jerk Man will set you straight with some good all true shit and none of the shit that irks me. Hey Maxie baby, I still got them videos. You fill my cereal port perfectly. Bitch.
Back to the STEM Radio Show, where the same thing comes out of his mouth, Maxwell Silverhammer.
Yeah, welcome back to the shit that fucking cocksucking irks me. And so yeah, man, this is what was the whole blue card thing anyway? What was all that? Those blue cards that they had.
Are you talking to me?
Yeah.
Well, you're looking at him.
Whoa.
I mean, I don't answer unless somebody looks at me and talks to me. Brett, I'm over here. I'm over here on your right.
I know. But was
what was the question?
Okay, I was asking you about the blue cards. What was the whole reason for those? What were those?
Well, so that Metro, if they stopped you and they found a gun on you, they could see that it was registered to you and not stolen. It was basically.
Oh, okay.
Now, I had a break-in at my house, and one of my guns got stolen, and they know what, you know, I reported and whatnot, so they know if they ever get that gun by the serial number, they, I get it back one day, hopefully, and it won't cause the death of anyone, hopefully.
So you won't need the card now?
No, you just go buy a gun and go home with it. That's
okay,
it.
That's cool. And so now they can, but the gun's still registered to you, obviously, if something if somebody uses that gun.
That's the thing I don't understand. I don't know how they're going to do that. When they, if they do a traffic stop on you and you happen to have a gun, and they'll probably ask you if you do, I don't know how they're going to, how you prove it's your gun.
Well, that's it, you know, because like some, like you said, some scumbag could have stolen your gun and now they're using it. So, you know,
I haven't got a clue. In fact, when I see a cop, I'm going to ask him how they're going
to
do that.
Yeah, I would be interested to know, you know, because I think that would, that's one positive, because now, you know, this makes, this gives the gun, the gun Nazis.
Well, there's a lot of guns that, that do get stolen that are actually recovered and given back to the owners.
Well, yeah.
Because they know the serial number. You know.
Actually, my dad had a situation where he had a gun get stolen, and it was used for something, and he got his, he was able to get his gun back.
Yeah.
So, you know, you just, the thing is, you never want something to link to you.
Well, I'm going to find out, and I'll give you the info, and then next week when you do your show, you'll be able to tell people.
All right. I do my show.
The bottom line is.
I do my show every night, so I'm always.
Every night?
Yeah, Monday through Friday.
Oh, I just thought it was on Monday night.
Nope, Monday through Friday. I just had you come in on Monday because that was a good night for me.
Oh, I see. You're very selfish. Tuesday would have been better for me, actually.
Oh, really? See, you know why I had you? You know what my whole reason was?
I'm only kidding, bro.
I actually wanted you in tonight because I wanted you to meet Shelly, too, because I thought maybe you could go on her show as well.
Oh, cool.
That's why I figured you guys, but I guess you guys.
She doesn't swear, though, does she?
No, not like me.
It would probably be a very boring show for me.
Yeah, well, you know, this is a little more laid back, you know.
In so, any event.
Any event.
While I was, I neglected to tell you this, I was managing the Sporting House, as you very well know, and then right. I had a fight with Freddie, as you very well know,
mm-hmm.
and I left. I bought a company called Monterey's Pools, I became a pool contractor. So I built and serviced swimming pools in this town for 15 years. The running for the legislature was in the middle of that, and that probably is what caused my divorce, you know, which I'm not too unhappy about at this point in time.
Now, but at the time, I'm sure you were.
At the time, it was very traumatic.
Well, it's, you know, that's one of those things where, you know, at the time, you're like, oh, fuck, why me? You know, but then you look back and you go, yeah, that kind of needed to happen, you know?
Then after the, I was in a very, very bad automobile accident back in 99, and I've had two back surgeries, and I was on workers' comp, and they actually followed me around to make sure I wasn't working. In fact, the car would be parked down on my street at the end of the block, waiting for me to come out of my house, and they followed me all over town for about a month.
Wow.
Well. And I proved to them that I wasn't working. And while I was proving to them that I wasn't working, all my employees stole everything from me at the office.
Oh,
so I had
shit.
To close the company down in October of 99. And then I was, like I said, I was on workers' comp. I got a settlement with them eventually, and I still have medical from my back with them as it gets worse, and it does as I get older. But I was retired for 10 years, and then I got a call from a gentleman I served in the legislature with by the name of John Bonaventura, who was running for Las Vegas Township Constable office. And he told me that I needed to go to work for him, and I said, I do not need to go to work. I am enjoying my retirement. And he made me an offer I couldn't refuse, and he wanted me to work for him as the public information officer and the chief operating officer of the constable's office.
Huh.
The problem that I had, and if you noticed the news or read papers or whatever, watched television, you know that the constable got into an awful lot of trouble in the 4 years that he was there. And the county commission went ahead and abolished the office. So as of January the 2nd of this year, Metro took it over.
So
they never really did abolish it. They just abolished it so they could get rid of the constable.
Well, you need, I mean, you do need a constable, right, for evictions and, you know.
Well, the constable's offices, and there are 11 in Clark County, by the way. Every township has a constable. What they do is basically enforce civil law.
Hmm. Okay.
That would be the out-of-state license plates. If you come move here and you don't change your license plate or driver's license within the 30 days, you're breaking the law. That we did evictions. Anything civilly, if the trash was built up on a piece of property, the neighbors didn't like it, we went in and did something about that.
What's going on?
And we served court papers. We served, as a matter of fact, in the 4 years, we served almost 380,000 court papers. Did over 100,000 evictions.
So, well, I mean, especially now, you know, with this, the whole thing with, you know, people, you said 2010 is when you went in there, right?
I was, well, he got elected in 10 and started serving in 11.
Okay. Well, that was a big time for a lot of evictions because, you know, that was the market, you know, the market crash when everybody was buying five or six condos and trying to rent them all out.
Of course, that started a problem with the real estate business because the banks who were evicting these people and taking possession of the homes they couldn't put all of these houses on the market at one time because the price would be, you know, minimal. So they would only release about 5,000 a month for sale. They've still got 40,000 homes, vacant homes in Clark County in inventory.
That they're holding hostage. Why are they?
Well, if they let them go, you know, the prices have gone up quite a bit, as you know, I'm sure.
Oh.
But if they flood the market, it'll drop again. So they're being very, very...
So they're looking out for us? Is that what you're saying?
No, they're looking out for them.
I know. I'm being sarcastic.
It's all a matter of dollars, as everything else has become in this town.
Right. Well, of course. So that's what it is. They're trying to maximize their money.
Exactly. Exactly.
Wow. Yeah, because I would think you guys were doing... you know, pretty good with all the, you know, evictions and whatever.
Well, we never had a problem with the office. The biggest problem was with the constable. I mean, he was doing things that just created a lot of people to look into the office, and what they found was not some very nice things. You know, he just went wild. He thought that he was president of the country, I guess. I don't know.
Oh, man. Well, you know, you get a little bit of power, and that's what you think, you know, that you're...
But you know what pisses me off more than anything, Brett? I can say piss, can I?
I don't think you should have to worry about anything else on here.
In any event, what makes me really mad about this is that he basically hired me and paid me a tremendous amount of money to watch his back. Because I was so politically connected, I knew everybody in town just about, and I was, you know, supposed to watch his back and kind of push him in the right direction, but he never listened to me.
Oh, so you were supposed to be an advisor, basically.
Yeah, exactly. And he never listened to me. He went and did what he wanted to do. Basically, the office ran so well that all he had to do was come in on Thursday, sign the checks, and go on vacation.
Wow.
He didn't even have to be in the office, you know.
Wow.
But that's life, and so now I'm retired again.
So Metro now does all the constable type work
in that office.
Oh wow!
There are still 10 active constables in Clark County.
Wonder how they're doing. I wonder if they're doing what they should.
Well, you don't read about them or hear about them, so they're doing well.
Okay.
You'd hear.
Uh-huh. Oh yeah, because you know our media always, you know. They look out for the best interest of us, you know, as citizens.
You know, interestingly enough, Las Vegas Township Constable's Office worked on a what they call an enterprise fund. The money that they collected for their duties went into this fund, which was called an enterprise fund. Hmm. All the other constables get to keep everything they make.
Oh.
They pay the county the minimal amount of money that they owe them for county help that the county provides, and whatever their cost of doing business is, and then the constable gets to put all the rest of that money in his pocket.
Wow, that's his? That's take-home
yes,
pay?
Yes, absolutely.
Holy shit.
Now, I understand that since they abolished the Las Vegas constable, that they also put the Henderson constable and the North Las Vegas constable on enterprise funds, so they'll be getting a salary now. They won't be able to steal the money.
Oh, so they're gonna regulate it a little bit, huh?
Yes, it's about time too.
Yeah. Well, see, that's what I'm saying. It's you know, I always joke that everybody either pays each other off or sucks each other off. So.
Well,
know.
Probably both.
That's probably the case.
Some are getting paid to suck, and some are paying to get sucked. You know, it's
right.
It's the way business is done, Brett.
Yeah, that's the problem. You know.
You know, the one bottom line that's interesting to me is that. There's a couple of court cases still going on in state in federal court, by the way. The law specifically states that the Clark County Commission can abolish the office of constable if they find it not to be necessary. In court, they never proved that it was not necessary. They just went ahead and abolished the office. It then goes on to say if the office is abolished and the constable runs for re-election and is elected, the abolishment goes away.
So
now,
okay.
Assistant county manager calls up the head of the election department and says, take Bonaventura's name off the ballot. Why? Well, because we abolished the office. There won't be any need for him. So they removed him from the office. In so doing, violated his civil rights, number one, because the abolishment was illegal, number two.
Right, because now you're saying he can't run
again.
So that's
what the lawsuit is going on about. Now, if he happens to win that lawsuit, they're going to have some kind of an election and put him, you know, let him run for I'm not saying he would win.
Right.
But I'm just saying, you know, to satisfy his rights, I would think they'd have to have an election and let him run for office.
So you have to give him a fair shot.
I would think. I'm not an attorney, but I think that's what would have to happen.
Wow. Man. So
either that or there would be a very, very big financial settlement along from the county, you know.
How long do you think this case is going to drag for?
Well, it's been in the courts now for about a year and a half.
Wow.
Maybe 2 years now.
So it may be a little bit yet before we have a real constable.
You know, the all of the state courts, in my opinion, are governed by the county commission anyway. The county commission signs their checks. I don't think they're partial at all. That's my own personal opinion now. I think that there was one or two cases that we got ruled against that we should have got ruled for legally, but we didn't. And I don't think that the judges want to make waves, you know, for the county commission.
Well, you know, too, and if it's being fought, it's not being sought.
That's why we went to federal court with this other case, because I think that's on the up and up.
I don't know
my opinion.
I don't know what courts are on the up and up or what anything is on the up and up anymore, you know?
Well, sometimes you got to pretend it's on the up and up, otherwise you lose sleep. You know, I mean, you can't. You have to.
Yeah, I guess
play the game. Play the game.
Well, if you're in that, you know, that's why I kind of try to stay away from it. You know, I just talk shit about it and complain. You know, that's what I do. That's my civil duty.
And I think you should be commended for it. Actually,
well,
I'm surprised the mayor hasn't given you a citation.
Well, you know, we're internet radio, so pretty much it's out of his...
Very few of us do our duty, you know.
It's actually, you know what, I got no complaints with, you know, the Goodmans are all right. Mayor Goodman, he gave me back when I was doing the suicide prevention hotline, I got an award, and he actually came down and told me it was a mug, but he actually came down and explained...
Was it full of gin? I mean, a mug full of gin would have been something.
That would have been awesome. Well, and he would have loved
or
that.
Or a bottle, anyway.
He would have loved that. Well, because he likes his alcohol, you know.
Well, that's why the cup of the mug was empty.
But he drank
full
from
of
it.
Gin and he drank it.
He's like, I'm going to kill this off before we give it to him. He won't know the difference. No, he actually came down and explained after he handed me the mug. He explained what it was. He's like, it's a mug. It's got a picture of a dog on it, and it says this. And I thought that was kind of cool. Like, wow, you actually took time to come down, and you know, you understood that I couldn't see what was on the.
Yeah, but then wouldn't you think that maybe it doesn't have anything painted on it? Maybe it's just a fucking white plain mug. Maybe it's not even a mug. Maybe it didn't have a handle. Maybe it was just a glass cup.
You know,
you never thought about that, did you?
Yeah, well, no, you know what I did. It felt like a mug, so I'm like, oh, fuck it, it's a mug. I'm going to use it.
And did you? Did you use it?
Yeah, you know, I'm not a big coffee drinker.
Well, you don't have to, you put gin in it. You don't have to put coffee
in it. I'm sure I did
it.
Something with it at some point, whether it was coffee, whether it was my own semen, I don't know.
But discharge that much, a cupful? Boy, you're a hell of a man, Brett.
Well, though, you know, I don't know if I could fill a full cup.
You've come a long way from the sporting house.
Yeah, I have come a long way, haven't I?
We got to tell people how we met again. I think that that's a really wild thing.
Okay, yeah, yeah. I mean,
you were, how old were you when you were?
God, I had to be about 8 or 9.
8 or 9. And my kid was about that, and he was in there all the time, too. So,
see,
but in any event, I used to, as you know, I used to love to play this this one video game.
Q-Bert.
There, yeah, Q-Bert, yeah. Q-Bert. And I got pretty good at it, actually.
Oh, you were the man at Q-Bert. My dad idolized you because he was like, you know, Lou's already up to level 8. And we're just like, shit, Dad, you can barely get to level 4.
Well, I, for what it's worth, I idolize your dad. I mean, I was in the emergency room almost every week. He saved my life. He stitched me up, you know. So it's mutual with he and I.
Right, right.
In any event, I don't know, how did we do this again now? How did we get in touch with each other the first time?
Oh, it was Facebook. You're talking about
did
how
you contact me?
Yeah, you know what happened? I heard you on Steve's show. And somehow I found you. Steve Sanson.
Oh, really? God, that was a long time ago.
Yeah, that was, God, 3-4 years ago or so.
Yeah.
And or somehow I found you. I don't know, either that or it's...
On Facebook?
Yeah, it was on Facebook. Okay. It either suggested you or something, you know, and I said, holy shit, I know who that is. But I can't even remember because I was listening to Steve's show. I heard you. Maybe you gave an email address. I don't know. There was somehow I was able to find you on Facebook. So I added you, and I think I even sent you a message, and I never heard back. I'm like, oh, typical dickhead politician. So I just...
Former.
Former. Oh, you're right. Former. I'm not a dickhead anymore. I used to be. So anyway, I sent you a message. You hadn't responded, and it had been a couple years.
Well, I hadn't. This last time was the first time I've ever got anything from you.
Well, and
I don't remember anything before that.
I think you responded to a post that I put up.
I probably did.
And then you said, hey, is this, you know, Maxwell from the Sporting House? And I was like, yeah, man, that's what I've been trying to tell you.
Well, the funny thing is, I had just gotten on Facebook. I refused to be on Facebook.
Oh.
But this fellow this Nelson Sardelli, I don't know if you know who he is. He used to be a headliner here in town, is one of my dearest friends. In fact, we'll get into that. Every Saturday we have with show business people, we have a brunch up at the Bagel Cafe. I'll talk to you about that.
Oh, okay.
But in any event, he said, you've got to get on Facebook, and they're all political, and everybody's beating Obama up, and blah, blah. And I said, okay, let me try it. So I made a big mistake and tried it. And then once you try it, it's like addicted.
Oh,
you
get
addicted to it. Because you say something, and then some asshole comes back and says something and calls you a dick, and so you want to call him an asshole again, you know, and it becomes addictive.
Oh, yeah. No, I've had some, I don't know if you saw my post where I had a thing. I was talking about this guy put up something about, you
That's
know,
how we met. That was that post.
Was it that?
Well, yes.
Actually, no, I was talking about the Confederate
flag. I think I defended. Didn't I defend you in a post you made, I think? Some guy was really beating
was
me up.
Something about my blindness, though. Remember?
Yes, yes, yes.
Something
yes.
I said, and I was bitching about.
Yeah, and I think I defended you, and that's how we got
And we started talking again.
Yes.
Yep. And then you were like, hey, man, when can we see each other? And I'm like, then I find out you live very close to where I live.
Yeah, we live 4 blocks from each other all these years. How long have you lived there?
Since 1998.
And I bought the house in 83, so I've been there all this time.
Wow.
I mean, that's amazing when you stop to think about it.
Well, that's it. It's kind of funny. Somebody could be your neighbor, and you don't fucking know it. You know, that's the mentality of Vegas, though. It's like...
The funny thing is, you don't look anything like you did when you were at the Sporting House.
Well, gee, I
wonder
even
why. You had hair.
I had hair. I put on weight.
You put a few pounds on. Got a little taller.
Did you expect me to look as if I did when I was 9?
Well, yeah, it would have been nice. I mean, I remembered you that way. You know, you're a whole new person this way.
Oh, yeah. Well, you probably, hell, you may even ran into me at some point and not even know it was me.
Could have been. And certainly you would have never recognized me.
Oh, no. Not in a million years. Unless you said your name. It's kind of cool hooking back up. But you're right about that Facebook shit. I just had something this weekend, as a matter of fact. This guy put up something about... So, you know, the Confederate flag thing's big now. Everybody's on this.
I think it sucks, too. They're making a big thing out of nothing, in my opinion.
Well, I mean, how long has that goddamn flag been around?
Forever.
I mean, now, all of a sudden, in 2015, it's caused so much heartache and pain.
But it's a battle flag to start with. It was a battle flag for the Civil War.
Well, yeah.
It's not a national Southern flag, for Christ's sake.
It's a part of history, though.
Yes, it is.
You know, it's just part of history. You know, I mean, you can't. take history out and say, well.
Well, you know, the country, in my opinion, again, I got a lot of opinions tonight, I know, but the country is becoming too politically correct.
That's the problem. That's the problem. And, you know, like my friend was saying, it's not freedom of speech. Now we have freedom from speech.
Yes.
You know, so everybody, you can't say this. There's certain words you can't say.
And that's bullshit.
Total bullshit. That's why we have shows like this, because we just say them all. And, you know, this guy had put up something on Facebook about, can you believe this idiot was flying a Confederate flag on Independence Day? So I commented, this woman had commented and said, what an idiot, he's a fucking asshole, blah, blah, blah. So I commented back.
Did she really say that?
Something to that effect.
I asked you to get her phone number for me.
She said something about the guy being a bigot or something, or you know, what a bigot, or bigots are stupid or something. So then I commented. I said, well, you got to remember, it is Independence Day. Independence is free speech, and flying that flag is a form of free speech. So then she started in on me about being a bigot and, you know, how I'm a hateful person and this, that, and whatever. And so then I attack her again. And then she says, well, you need to calm down. You know, you just jumped the gun and you just did that. And I'm like, oh, because I fucking tore your argument up, you know. So anyway, I posted on Facebook about it. And I didn't know if you saw that one.
I don't recall seeing that one, but she was...
Oh yeah.
Every day there's like 100 of them. It's just, and you go through them, and it really is addictive. It is.
Oh, it is.
I'm sorry I even got involved with it at this point.
Well, like you said, you're right. You know, you get a Facebook argument going, and you know, all of a sudden, you know, you're like, I want to see what that fucker just said. You know, and you go look at the, you know, at the thing, and you get a notification that six people just responded to it, and you're just like. Oh, wow.
The things that I really like, though, on Facebook are the animal things. The puppies and the kittens and all the, you know.
You're talking about some cats being mutilated and
no,
shit?
No, 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 not that. That I hate that stuff. I'd like to get my gun and go shoot those assholes.
Oh, okay, okay.
But it's the cute stuff. It's the little kitties and the horse found a big tub of water and he got in and he started playing with it and kicking it. And it was really cute. You know,
see the one I just posted up on mine? I don't think we're friends, but... with a wiener dog, actually, for 4th of July, they were lighting off one of those Roman candles, and he ran up and grabbed the side of it and actually started running with it, and it was shooting everybody as he's running by.
Wow. See,
that's funny.
These are things I miss because they're visual. So, yeah. Obviously, I never would get those. Or then you get, Jerkman, did you see what Monica posted on my wall? It was some picture, and I said, what the fuck is that?
When did she do it, today?
It was, I think, yesterday.
Maxwell's?
No, my personal.
Okay, I'll check it out.
Yeah. And she posted something up there, and I said, what is... Well, my response was kind of, I go, what the fuck is that? Because I don't know, when people post pictures on my wall, you know, it could be anything. It could be a child getting sodomized or some shit. And I'm like, I don't want that on my wall, you know? So that's when I, you know, was like, what the fuck is that? And then she was like, well, she goes, something you wouldn't understand. And I'm like, then why'd you post it on my wall? And she's like, well, you made a comment about 4th of July being a blind man's holiday, because which it is. It's, you know, everything makes noise and explodes and whistles and, you know, it's a totally, you know, it's a noisy holiday. So my kind of holiday. Anyway, she was trying to be friendly but stupid in the process because, you know.
Here's what it says.
She must be a lib.
Why do we close our eyes when we pray, cry, kiss, or dream? Because the most beautiful things in life are not seen but felt by the heart.
Oh, that sounds like an SMJ, doesn't it?
No.
No?
No.
I don't know. You're getting all fuzzy. Warm
there was
fuzzy.
A cute one that I saw the other day. It was two dogs were in the back seat, standing on the back seat of a car when it was driving. I guess their mom and dad or whatever. And the woman is handling, one is a Yorkie and one is a wiener schnitzel dog. Mm-hmm. And she's holding the cone, and the Yorkie is licking it very daintily, you know. Hmm. And the other one is just kind of staring at him. Really cute. And then after he licks it, you know, I guess he got his fill. The wiener dog just grabs the whole goddamn thing in his mouth.
Oh, wow.
It was really funny. But that's the kind of stuff, the funny animal stuff, not the guys that burn the dogs and all
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I was just saying,
stomping the animals, and that's ridiculous.
I can't believe that there's that much of it goes on still in this country.
Yeah, and that they even post it, and they're proud of it. It's just, it's sickening.
Yeah, absolutely disgusting.
Yeah, the fact people even post that kind of shit. I mean, I can see if you're a hunter, And you want to show what you bagged over the weekend, you know,
but
whatever.
A lot of that stuff is even ridiculous.
You see this girl in Africa just shot
that giraffe.
You see that?
Yeah, I saw
that. Wasn't that disgusting?
And the guy that they actually took the front part of the elephant's head off just because, when it was eaten, just because.
Terrible.
And they went take pictures with it. And I did see the one where a guy actually went out and was trying to kill the elephant and take a picture with it. Well, the elephant got him first.
Yeah.
I thought, good for you.
Yeah, good for
you. Now
him.
The elephant should have had somebody pull a picture while held him up dead.
There's some really, really cute animal stuff on there, though. That really, the rest of the crap I could do without, frankly.
Mm. Mm. Well, hey, it's Facebook for you.
I'd like to find a way to make some money off of it. Then I'd be happy.
Well, Mark Zuckerberg did.
Yeah, Zuckerberg did. He's the only person who's going to make money off that shit. Anyway, we'll be right back, bitches.
If you're a fan of hip-hop and R&B, join me, the Brubra Ren, for a full non-stop hour of back-to-back slappers.
Back-to-back slappers.
Where the playlist spans from genres like R&B, soul.
R&B, soul.
Sitting on 25 mil, I'm in the building and I'm feeling myself. Rest in peace, Mac Dre. I'ma do it for the bay, okay? Getting paid, we'll holler whenever that stop. My team good, we don't really need a mascot.
Classic throwbacks, life.
Well, I'm beeping and I'm creeping and I'm creeping. But I damn near got caught, cause my beeper kept beeping. Now it's time for me to make my impression felt. So sit back, relax, and strap on your seatbelt. You've never been on a ride like this before.
Every Friday night at 9 o'clock Pacific Standard Time.
Saturday at midnight Eastern Standard Time.
Only on the Tough Love Show on JNJ.FM.
Hey, most people don't plan to fail, but a lot of people fail to plan, and it really don't have to be like that.
What you know about an IRA or a tax deferred 401k? What you gotta pay to the government? Ever heard of a tax exempt retirement? That's info most folks don't know. What you gonna do if you live too long? What you gonna do if you die too soon? Can your spouse afford the house? Will your family go bankrupt if you get sick? You got a plan in place to cover medical debt? I'm not talking about Advil, I'm speaking on long-term ill. You ever seen a bill from that home where Big Mama went to live? It's like $73,000 a year. How you gonna pay for that? 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 You work hard every day, but you really don't like it. You're looking at a retirement crisis. Got a good education, got a good job. Got the age and the time, but still got robbed in 2008 when the market crashed. Wanna tell your boss to kiss your bus pass, but you can't cause you upside down. And your savings on life support right now. Said you can't cause you upside down. And your savings on life support right now. So you wake up in the morning and you put on your game face. Then you run out the house late, headed to the same place. On the bus like I'm stuck, 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 stuck. In your car like I'm stuck, 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 stuck. What you need is a solution. More income and less confusion. What you gonna do? Where you gonna go? Who you gonna talk to get the info? And get money. You can talk to me. You can talk to me. You can talk to me. We got what you need. Or you can join the team. Build yourself and build your wealth by sharing what you learn with somebody else. Each one teach one how money works. Stay compliant so nobody gets hurt. Move like a union, be ambitious. We all independent, follow the system. Move like a union, be ambitious. We all independent, follow the system. Hey, this is Travis. This song was recorded to get your attention. I have some powerful financial information that you should hear. The things that you need to put in place for a solid financial foundation in case you live too long, die too soon,
If you become disabled or need to go into a home, or if you simply need access to a tax-free supplemental retirement or emergency fund, we have the information to put these proper plans in place in case any of these things happen. Contact me at my email. That's tketonwfg@gmail.com. That's tketonwfg@gmail.com. Let's set up an appointment, sit down at the kitchen table or coffee shop somewhere. I'll show you the information. If you have the need and the means, let's get it done. Or if you're looking for a business with a great compensation plan and a proven system, you should join the team. I know this business isn't for everyone, but it's one of those rare situations where if we all follow the system, it can be a win for all involved. The companies win, the clients win, or the families win, the brokers win. We're entrepreneurs, we're our own bosses, everyone is a broker. We can make good money and travel around the world on the company's dime. Let's at least try to do it.
At last, the wait's finally over. Be Sick returns from a long hiatus with a brand new album entitled Mr. Zero Tolerance.
Available for digital download only.
Be Sick's no punches pulled approach on the mic gives listeners what they want, as well as gives the rap game a well-deserved kick in the ass with such hard-hitting gems as the title track, Mr. Zero Tolerance.
Mr. Zero fucking tolerance, you think that you're fun. My tongue's from busting the gun, my toleration is nuts. Fucking buster and I'm pissed off.
Or the laid-back, fun-filled street anthem entitled Change of Pace, featuring Ghost.
This is something to bump as a gift to the haters. So turn it up loud just to piss off your neighbors. And if you out rolling, you be getting a ticket. And if you
straight to the guts, blind to the facts.
Blind to the facts that you're blind to the trap. Blind to the facts that with time we adapt. Blind to the facts of what you don't understand. Blind to the facts by the media scams. Blind to the facts of what you read in the book. Blind to the facts.
Download your copy today of Mr. Zero Tolerance from www.cdbaby.com or go to www.cdbaby.com/cd/bsick2. Download your copy today. Keep the realness in the rap game.
Yee! What up, though? It's the undeniable JT Money, a.k.a. the Bitchizer, and you tuned in to STEM Radio with Maxwell Silverhammer and GJ the Jerkman. Heavy that. And guess what? They hate hoes almost as much as I do. So don't sleep on these cats. And speaking of sleeping, don't forget to check out my new single, Hustlin', from my new project, Morning Wood. It's going down heavy, baby. And speaking of being out, I'm out like a busted traffic, like you already know. Get him, Jay!
We think it's the banning of
anonymous. And if you don't know, you better ask somebody. My boy Maxwell Silverhammer and my bottom bitch jerk man will set you straight with some good all true shit and none of that shit that irks me. Hey Maxie baby, I still got them videos. You fill my cereal port perfectly. Bitch.
Back to the STEM Radio Show with the man behind the mic. Believes older women are the bomb. Only three have died in his bed so far. Maxwell Silverhammer.
Hell yeah. I hope you guys weren't believing all that. So, Lou, we should talk about the RTC a little bit, shouldn't we? You there?
You talking to me?
Yeah.
Oh, are you? Sorry, I was busy.
Were you texting?
He was Facebooking.
Oh, see, look. He's in his Facebook zone. We are back.
Okay.
Holy shit.
I'm here.
We totally lost you there. I'm like, oh, what happened? Is he dead? I'm just going to have Jerkman give you mouth to mouth because that's.
Well, I'm arm's reach, you know. You could just reach over and feel me if you want.
Yeah. Like I said, I would let Jerkman do all that stuff. That'll be his department. He can grow up on you.
Well, you know, at my age, you go into these trances and sometimes you just don't know where you are.
Get caught up in the zone, huh? So, you know, we should talk about the RTC.
I don't know that much about it.
Really?
I'll try to chip in.
Okay. It's just kind of funny, you know, some of the stuff they get. I always say RTC stands for really talented criminals. And
And you use them a lot.
Well, I have to.
Well, is it, are you guilty by association?
I have no. Oh no. I'm simply a victim.
I see.
No, you know what? It's fairly decent, but there are just certain things that they do sometimes that you wonder, like.
Well, you told me of an incident that happened, I think, what, last week or something.
This was a couple months ago where I got left.
Yeah.
Where they left me.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was one. You know, so, and you always got to be prepared for everything, you know, whatever these drivers might do, you know, because you're right, some will leave you, you know, and then they kind of take the side of the driver, you know, well, you should have been outside. Well, it's 115 degrees. I'm not going to stand outside, and I can wait right in the comfort of my own apartment.
Especially without a hat on, right?
Yeah, well, yeah, I probably should be wearing a hat, right? If I'm out there in that sun. But, you know, or like now they had this, there was another service that used to be called ITN. And I guess supposedly they went tits up and lights out. And they were purchased by the Transit Coalition. And now they're called Silver Riders. And so, yeah, Silver Riders is now the new company. But every time I call them, I can never get rides with them. They seem...
Are they government funded?
Well, that's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking they may be government funded. The fact that, you know, the Transit Coalition.
Yeah, but RTC wouldn't allow that, I don't think.
No, see,
I don't think they would allow competition.
To me, well, that's it. I think the RTC bought them out so that way they can knock out the competition.
Well, that's a different story.
You know? So that's what I'm thinking is going on there.
Do you think the people that drive those buses are the same ones that used to be school bus drivers?
You know, it's very possible. Some of them I've talked to. well, you know, some were old ex-truckers. Some did construction. You know, there's different groups of people there that I've ridden with. You know, some were in the military. So a lot of them have stories, interesting stories. So, but you know that what they do is they subcontract basically with you know, like Viola or First Transit or one of those companies. So RTC pays them, basically.
Maybe Uber will come along and take that over as well.
I wonder. You think?
Well, you know, maybe I'll go buy a bus and see what happens.
Somebody told me, what is it, September 3rd. It was supposed to be July 3rd when Uber was taken over, but it's now September 3rd.
I understand they are now.
Well, I just talked to somebody today, and they said, no, it's not till September 3rd.
Oh.
So apparently there was a pushback, I guess, you know, something with contracts. You know the ass fuckery that needs to occur.
What's your opinion with that? You think it's a good thing?
Uber?
Yeah.
Oh, I think it's great because your fare's already calculated. They can't pull this, you know, the thing that taxis do a lot of time. You know, and I don't take cabs very much. You know, I know my way around, so, you know, these fucking, you know, dune coons can't pull one over on me too quick. But, you know, they will try if given the chance, you know, of taking you down different streets and taking
you
way out of
your... Well, they do that. What do they call that? Long hauling or short hauling, I think.
Long hauling, I think.
Is it long? Well, either or. But they go out from the airport and they go down, you know, over the freeway and come down I-15. And they say it's longer in distance, but shorter in time.
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
And now they tell their customers that they got gigged for it. So they said, look, the fares, do you want the long ride or the quick ride?
They'll ask you.
Well, and they let them make the choice, you know.
I don't know. The cab I took, the guy was really good. And, you know, I mean, he seemed honest enough. And, you know, I knew exactly where I was going. So I was like, okay, now you go take this street to this street. You know, I was given the direction. So he couldn't pull anything off, you know. And believe me, I know if you've turned on a street when you shouldn't have. You know, I can feel it. So, yeah, we could use a lot better transportation system here, though. I mean, our buses, the fixed routes come late all the time. Or you see them and they say they're out of service, which...
You know, there was a guy... I didn't mean to interrupt you.
Oh, no, go ahead.
There was a guy, his name was Alex Shufi. I don't know if you remember that name or heard of it.
Doesn't
but he
sound
was
familiar.
The president of the Sahara Hotel way back in the late 50s. And then when Kirk Kerkorian bought the Flamingo, he brought Alex and his crew over from the Sahara to the Flamingo. And there they plotted to build and run the International Hotel. And he had it, when he got to the, I lived with him for 2 years, so I know all about this stuff. He had an idea way back in the late 60s. He says, you know, we ought to build a monorail down the middle of the strip.
Oh, that was
an off-ramp into each hotel. Huh. You know, that was an idea that nobody had thought of prior to that.
Right.
Needless to say, he couldn't get it on, but it was the public knowledge way back then. That would have been great.
Well, the monorail should go all over the valley.
Well,
shouldn't
I,
it?
But it should go that the you mean the existing one?
Yeah, or any
well,
monorail.
I think it should go right now. I think they should extend it to downtown and to the airport.
I don't know. It just seems like a lot of stuff is kind of set up for tourists, and you know, us locals get the shaft. You know, in a lot of cases.
Well, I know, but the cabs are all a bunch of crooks, you know, and it would straighten them out real quick.
Well, that's it. That's one reason why we need to do that.
I thought that, you know, as long as they're going to, if they've got most of it done already, I mean, just two more legs, one to downtown and one to the airport. People can sightsee at the same time they're going where they're going.
I guess for me, it would be nice to have more options for transportation than just one thing.
How about a subway?
Well, subway would be nice if they had that. You know, there's certain cities like New York and, you know, Chicago and whatnot, where everybody takes public transportation. You know, you don't really, people don't drive, you know. And
well, only because they can't, Brett.
Well.
You ever tried driving in New York?
Yeah, actually, I've ridden a car in New York, and you're right, it's very, very slow.
You can't, it's impossible. Why go rent a car to drive from the airport to your hotel and park it for a week?
Yeah.
Take cabs.
Well, and that's, actually somebody did that. I had a friend in town that actually went and did that where, you know, they parked their car in valet and just took cabs all around.
Here? Well,
yeah.
Yeah.
Which I think is a rip, you know, anyway.
A rip for who?
For the person, you know, the tourists.
You know that, speaking of tourists and valets, this is the only, in my, as far as I know, my knowledge of traveling all over and seeing things, this is the only place where you can park in a hotel and not be charged for it.
Really?
You ever stop and think about that?
That's true. Well, you're right, because there are other places where they do charge you for parking.
I go into Century City and I stay at the Century Plaza Hotel, and it's $26 a night.
God damn.
To park your car.
Now, where is that?
It's on Century Avenue of the Stars in Century City in Los Angeles.
Oh, okay. I'm like, where's Century City?
Right next to where 20th Century Fox is, as a matter of fact.
Oh, okay. Okay, so it's like Hollywood area, huh?
Yes. Well, no, it's actually, it's Century City. Hollywood would be northwest.
Oh, okay.
Santa Monica would be east.
Okay.
I mean west, not east. I'm a little turned around.
Yeah.
Well, if I turn my chair around, I'll be facing.
There you go. See?
But it's not a big thing, but you can still park your car further as long as you want and tip the guy a buck.
Yeah. Nice.
Isn't that amazing for this town?
Well,
who would have thought they would have been charging by now, wouldn't they?
Well, yeah, you'd think. You know, if they find some way to charge you in some way. You know, it's just, I think they could improve transportation. It's tough when you don't drive out here. You know, I mean, you're pretty much stuck with city buses that aren't reliable, or, you know, in my case, you got paratransit, which is fairly reliable, but even then, you know, I mean,
you know something, if you don't do your mass transit at the beginning when the city is just starting to grow, it becomes a real problem to add it after.
So, and that's kind of what happened here, because we didn't really get any kind of mass transit till what, 92? 93?
Yeah, but what I'm saying now, to put mass transit in, unless they do either elevated or subway, it's going to disrupt the traffic flow.
Oh, I got you. Yeah, because now there's so much traffic.
I mean,
traffic.
Look at it now. You got three lanes on a street, and then a bus comes up in the right lane. So now you're in the right lane. Now you got to move over to the center lane, you know. And if the bus gets hit by light and you're behind it, you're screwed.
Well, what about all this construction? You know, I mean, is that all necessary? I don't think so, right? You know,
if what is?
Talk about disrupting traffic, all that construction. You know,
it seems that they have enough juice to be able to disrupt traffic.
Well, there you go.
I can't believe. Look, when the hotels on the strip are starting to do all these remodeling, you know,
mm-hmm.
they close off that lane.
Right. Just for
them
to remodel.
They get a permit and they close off that lane and it really disrupts traffic, yes.
Right. So here it is, you're remodeling a hotel, which has nothing to do with the streets and the roads, yet they can close off the streets.
I found a new one today. I'm going out 215. I'm going out west to the dentist, And there's a, right before you get to the Sunset Drive turnoff, there's a big section of freeway that kind of curves around. And the whole non-freeway side of it is a big empty lot that evidently they're going to be building something on. So now the off-ramp is normally two lanes. So now they have it only one lane because they're not using that other lane, but they don't want any cars near the dirt, I guess. I don't know what it is.
Wow.
But it's ridiculous. And it really, you know, it upsets traffic.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I think they're starting that carpool fine shit, aren't they? Isn't there a carpool tax or a car?
I hadn't heard about that.
Oh, because I know California does that.
How can they possibly do that?
They.
If you want to take seven people to work, you just say, hey, these are my friends.
Well, yeah.
How are they going to tax you?
But I know California has a carpool something with if you have more than so many people in the car. I forget how it works.
I know, but that seems to me that would be against your constitutional rights.
Sure.
Let alone your voting rights.
But look what they do all the time. You know?
I don't know how they could tax you that way for that. You can take your friends. I mean, you could pile 20 friends in your car if you can get them in.
Right.
How can they tax you?
Well, are they
going to say it's illegal to have 20 people? Okay, you can only have six, so I'll take six.
Actually, what they're planning on doing is they're going to start using GPS to monitor everybody's phones and any kind of electronic device you have in your car, and they're actually going to start taxing you for every mile on everybody in your car that's detectable.
Here in town?
That's what they're talking about doing, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, they're talking about, they've already done it, I think, in Michigan.
I would think that there'd be lawsuits out the ass.
I would think so, and I would at least hope so, yes.
That's, California's doing it.
Yeah.
Well, I know that. But they do a lot of things that we don't want to do.
Yeah, well, there you go. Well, you know, here's the problem. You know, the Californians all come here and try to change this place into the shithole they left. You know, they're almost like, they're like bed bugs. You know, they come and they fuck up a new place, you know, and they're
very hard to get rid of.
Yes,
too.
And they're very hard to get rid of. Thank you. They're out for blood. Hey, that's what we should do. I'll do a Facebook posting. The many ways that Californians are like bed bugs. And I'll like do all these comparisons. Those were great, guys. But yeah, no, they're wanting to do that now, where they start taxing, you know, the mileage.
Taxation without representation, man.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, that's where they're trying to go.
They think they can fix a country by taxing it to death. It doesn't work that way. Never has, never will.
Yeah. So everything
is... You see that? You know, that's the basis for socialism, basically. Yes. To get everybody dependent on government.
Mm-hmm.
And the only way they can do that is if government taxes everybody.
Sure.
So you got to take all your money, then they will support. Then government will support you.
Yep. Exactly.
And then you're fucked.
Yeah, yep. Pretty much.
Well, but see, again, we're allowing it because we're going, well, this is great, man. We can sit back and let the government do this, and they'll help us with that and subsidize this. And meanwhile, it's like...
Stop to think about it. You can get a free cell phone, and you can get welfare, and you can get child care, and all kinds of shit. There's a woman that keeps having a baby, you know, every year just because her income keeps going up every month. Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. And this is the kind of shit.
There's a guy in New Orleans, his daughter and her husband, and I think they had four or five families living in this big home.
Mm-hmm.
And between all of them, they were all on wealth, on some sort of free, you know, income
government
program. Government assistance, yes. And they were making, collectively, they were making $220,000 a year, collectively.
Wow.
Off the government.
What? $220,000 a year?
Yes.
Holy shit.
Well, everybody was collecting whatever they could collect legally. That would be the welfare and the, you know, child care and, you know, I don't know what the programs are. But.
And the sad thing is the government sees this as, they're like, oh, this is great because they can cash in on it.
Well, keep in mind.
It all depends which government. I mean, the Reagan government would not. But the Obama government, of course. Because if everybody is dependent on government, then he's achieved what I think his goal really is.
What do you believe his goal is, honestly, in your opinion?
To turn us into a socialist.
Socialist country.
Socialist. Yeah. Okay.
I was mentioning to Brett earlier that the aliens
aliens?
The illegal immigrants.
Well, we do live in close to Area 51, so.
You know, he wants to bring those in by the hundreds of thousands. Mm. Every one of those is a vote.
Yeah.
It's a democratic vote. Everyone, there's no other reason for him to do it.
Well, he has opened up the borders. They have let a lot of people in. They've actually shipped them in black buses, I've heard, and deported them all over the East Coast and spread them out evenly across
the East Coast. Well, and the Muslims too. That's a whole different problem. But you know, because if enough of them get here, they're going to offend the way we live.
Right.
Well, see, but this is what Obama's just a puppet for them.
I think he was handpicked and groomed to be president of the United States.
Totally.
My opinion.
Totally. And this is the government's plan. You know, regardless of conservative, liberal, the two parties are working together, man. They're playing the same game.
Well, Bonner could stop this. He could have went and put up a lot of different laws and shot down a lot of stuff. A lot of the Republicans on that side could have, but nobody's done it yet as of now.
That's what I
don't understand why. And it makes no sense to me.
You know what the key that everybody should look at, and this is the reason that I say he was groomed and put in that place. How many people that you know of in your lifetimes that have been involved in politics have been scrutinized and vetted so heavily?
Right.
This guy won't give up anything. His whole past is a secret.
Yeah.
If he wasn't put there by somebody, because it's the somebody that's protecting him.
Yeah.
He's not doing it himself.
No,
no. He's being protected.
Obvious. Well, I mean, when we have Clinton, which I don't think was one of the greatest presidents either, but when he was ready to be impeached over a blowjob, I mean, and now we see all the stuff going on in this day and age with this administration, and nobody, I mean, they talk about it, but nobody's brought any kind of charges up. Nobody's investigated anything. They just leave
Trump
it to the wayside.
Did. Trump spent thousands of dollars trying to get his birth certificate, remember?
Yeah.
You can't get any of his records. It's college records. It's unheard of.
Mm.
So it's not him that's stopping it.
No.
It's a group of people that are stopping it.
Oh, yeah. No, somebody definitely wants to make sure that...
people with a major agenda that want something done.
Absolutely. Yep. I agree 100%.
Yep. That's it. They're playing for the same team, man. So...
And then you got this Jade Helm 15 coming up. I don't know if I've heard a lot of different things stating that it's going everywhere from martial law to the collapse of the dollar, which is right around the corner. You know, a lot of different reasons this could actually be going on.
Well, if they're messing with Texas, I think they're messing with the wrong state. Those Texans won't put up with much.
No.
Yeah, well, they already said that.
They all got guns.
But we all know what will happen there. That'll actually start a civil war is what will happen. Because then by that point, if the government's trying to take over local government, you know, and I heard that the governor of Texas actually is keeping an eye on with their own military, their own in-state military, on what's supposed to be going on with Jade Helm. If this does take place, I mean, we're going to be looking at a civil war in this country is what's going to happen.
Oh, yeah. No, it's can get ugly. But
I think he picked on the wrong state, though.
I mean,
when babies are born, their first president is a gun.
Yeah.
You're right.
But I've also seen that just now they announced it because Nevada was in on the Jade Helm. They just dropped us as part of the exercise.
Oh, we've been dropped? Oh.
They said Nevada has been dropped. I don't know if I believe that. I think that, you know... Anything that the government tells you, I think you wait 40 years to find out the truth.
Well, yeah, of course.
I'm at the point now that you can't believe anything they
say. Not at this point, yeah.
Nope. And that's it. You know, I mean, either way, they're going to be... it's all a plan. It's all an agenda that they've got.
Absolutely is. And those people that actually believe in Obama as a person or the Messiah, they are really fucking dumb.
Oh,
you know,
they're really dumb. They've got to realize this is a plan.
Mm-hmm. And the funny thing about it is that in a way, this man has actually kept his promise. He said he was going to change America. He has.
Sure fucking has.
Absolutely has.
When he said that, you know, when they were talking about the drone, predator drones flying over the United States, and he said, I got two words for you, predator drones. And everybody started laughing. He goes, I'm serious. And he was serious. He did do it. Everything that he said that everybody's found to be a joke, thinking this can't be coming from our president, he has done. You know, whether it's him solely, whether he's the puppet, doesn't matter. It's been done.
Right. It's happened.
Well, there is somebody pulling the strings.
Oh, yeah. No doubt.
He's not doing all of this on his own, I guarantee you.
No, because he would have been stopped by now. Bottom line.
Yeah. There's somebody that wants all this to happen. And, I think it's both parties. You know, regardless of who he had in, even if you had Romney win that thing, you would have had Romney care. You would have had...
You wouldn't have had Romney do it because Romney is rich...
That, you know, his Romney care is a very successful thing, by the way, in his state, in Michigan. Very successful. Well, they're not having the problems Obamacare has.
And it wouldn't have happened because, first of all, this is our first black president, they're saying. But,
right.
really, this is what you needed for it to happen and go this direction. You have a president now that's a mix, black and white. Mm-hmm. You know, now if something went wrong, the higher ups that put him in place could say, "Hey, look, that was our first black president."
Up.
You know, these racial issues and everything came from this directly. Had nothing to do with him being a president or what he did. It was just a racial issue that whites didn't like him because he was our first black president. It was easy to be a pass off if this stuff didn't go the way they wanted it to. Bottom line.
Yeah, but you know, he could have never got elected if it wasn't for whites.
Yeah, right. Yeah, and that's the whole thing. And
I mean, blacks, there aren't enough of them to elect him. Yeah. You know.
And then right. he's sitting here saying that it's a very racist country. Well, for being a racist country, I don't know how he got into office.
That's
then.
Part this, of the plan. Is sure. the race war is. Part of the
part
whole
of plan.
Plan.
Yeah, yep. you got to have the citizens uprising in order to beat them back down. You have to give them a reason to come out of their comfort zones and feel as though they have to stand up against the government, the oppression, in order for this to take place. And that's the problem. It's been slow waking for a lot of people that are coming around saying, "Oh, look, I can't believe this is going on." You know, so it's a slow taking, and I think that we need that, or they need that one little juice to push to get this thing. I mean, we've had Ferguson, we've had New York, we've had a lot of different riots, but just not enough to push it over the edge yet.
But the building blocks are in place. I mean,
they're setting. Yeah,
you got the Confederate flag thing. You hear more about white privilege. You know, more people are being fired for, you know, using racial slurs and, you know, in the media and things like that.
Well, they've also put out a list of things that are actually what they look for now, and a lot of it is veterans. You know, they're going against the veterans, saying when they come back, they put them on a watch list. Places like this, because we're not major media, we're just alternative media. So they right. keep an eye on stuff that we're saying and doing, and a bunch of other things that just go on in this country, which at one point in time would have been totally unheard of in this country. I mean, you don't go against your vets. Your vets are out there fighting for your freedoms.
That's what I'm saying.
But if you don't have any freedoms left, what do they care?
So, I'm here because of the vets.
Yeah,
you know,
right, exactly. Right.
We all are.
Yeah, yeah. And it's a shame the way this
treat
country's
them like crap too.
Yeah, it's a shame the way this country is headed. But you know, like you said, it takes. I think they want that to happen. They want us all to just finally say we're sick of this.
Well, obviously, the next election will tell the toll.
Mm-hmm.
Tell the tale. Actually,
yeah.
The problem is that he still has 17 or 18 months left to destroy the country.
He can do a lot.
That's
of
the
shit.
Problem.
Yeah.
I mean, you can do a lot on the way out the door.
And you know what amazes me? As much hate as this man evokes from people, mm-hmm. he has not been shot yet.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Yeah.
Nobody's
why hasn't he been shot yet? Well, the security is tight. That's bullshit. If a guy wants to shoot him, the guy's going to shoot him.
And the fact
look
that
at JFK.
Well, and the fact that they jumped over the fence a couple times, I mean, it can't
he's
be
got,
that damn tight.
I understand the security budget is almost triple from what a normal president would
be,
have.
Right. And I can understand that. I mean, he was our first black president, so racial things in the beginning. There were some people that were, you know, and... But like I said, as the administration has went on, he has not lied. He's done what he said. He's changed this country, not for the better. He didn't say it was going to be for the better. He said America had change coming, and we got the change that we all voted for.
Well, there you go. Be careful what you wish for.
Yeah. Obviously. Sometimes that's what they say. Be careful what you wish
well,
for.
Well, we didn't. They did.
No.
Yeah, they got the change that they voted for, because that's what it is. It's Electoral College. It puts them in place.
Yeah.
Anyway, we'll be right back.
And that's... That's one of the...
You're a fan of hip-hop and R&B, join me, the Bruh Ren, for a full non-stop hour of back-to-back slappers.
Back-to-back slappers.
Where the playlist spans from genres like R&B, soul.
R&B, soul.
Sitting on 25 mil, I'm in the building and I'm feeling myself. Rest in peace, Mac Dre. I'ma do it for the pay, okay? Getting paid, we'll holler whenever that stop. My team good, we don't really need a mascot.
Classic throwbacks, life.
Well, I'm beeping and I'm creeping and I'm creeping. But I damn near got caught, cause my beeper kept beeping. Now it's time for me to make my impression felt. So sit back, relax, and strap on your seatbelt. You've never been on a ride like this before.
Every Friday night at 9 o'clock Pacific Standard Time.
Saturday at midnight Eastern Standard Time.
Only on the Tough Love Show on J&J.FM.
Hey, hey, most people don't plan to fail, but a lot of people fail to plan, and it really don't have to be like that.
What you know about an IRA or a tax-deferred 401k? What you gotta pay to the government? Ever heard of a tax-exempt retirement? That's info most folks don't know. What you gonna do if you live too long? What you gonna do if you die too soon? Can your spouse afford the house? Will your family go bankrupt if you get sick? You got a plan in place to cover medical debt? I'm not talking about Advil. I'm speaking on long-term ill. You ever seen a bill from that home where Big Mama went to live? It's like $73,000 a year. How you gonna pay for that? 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 You work hard every day, but you really don't like it. You're looking at a retirement crisis. Got a good education, got a good job. Got the age and the time, but still got robbed in 2008 when the market crashed. Wanna tell your boss to kiss your bus pass, but you can't cause you upside down. And your savings on life support right now. Said you can't cause you upside down. And your savings on life support right now. So you wake up in the morning and you put on your game face. Then you run out the house late, headed to the same place. On the bus like I'm stuck, 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 stuck. In your car like I'm stuck, 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 stuck. What you need is a solution. More income and less confusion. What you gonna do? Where you gonna go? Who you gonna talk to get the info? And get money. You can talk to me. You can talk to me. You can talk to me. We got what you need. Or you can join the team. Build yourself and build your wealth by sharing what you learn with somebody else. Each one teach one how money works. Stay compliant so nobody gets hurt. Move like a union, be ambitious. We all independent, follow the system. Move like a union, be ambitious. We all independent, follow the system.
Hey, this is Travis. This song was recorded to get your attention. I have some powerful financial information that you should hear. The things that you need to put in place for a solid financial foundation in case you live too long, die too soon, if you become disabled or need to go into a home, or if you simply need access to a tax-free supplemental retirement or emergency fund. We have the information to put these proper plans in place in case any of these things happen. Contact me at my email. That's TKEETONWFG@gmail.com. That's TKEETONWFG@gmail.com. Let's set up an appointment, sit down at the kitchen table or coffee shop somewhere. I'll show you the information. If you have the need and the means, let's get it done. Or if you're looking for a business with a great compensation plan and a proven system, you should join the team. I know this business isn't for everyone, but it's one of those rare situations where if we all follow the system, it can be a win for all involved. The companies win, the clients win, or the families win, the brokers win. We're entrepreneurs, we're our own bosses. Everyone is a broker. We can make good money and travel around the world on the company's dime. Let's at least try to do it.
At last, the wait's finally over. B-Sick returns from a long hiatus with a brand new album entitled Mr. Zero Tolerance.
Available for digital download only.
B-Sick's no-punches-pulled approach on the mic gives listeners what they want, as well as gives the rap game a well-deserved kick in the ass. With such hard-hitting gems as the title track, Mr. Zero Tolerance.
Mr. Zero fucking tolerance, you think that you're fun. My tongue's replacing the gun, my toleration is nuts.
Or the laid-back, fun-filled street anthem entitled Change of Pace, featuring Ghost.
This is something to bump as a gift to the haters, so turn it up loud just to piss off your neighbors. And if you out rolling, you'll be getting a ticket. And if you
straight to the guts, blind to the facts.
Blind to the facts that you're blind to the trap. Blind to the facts that with time we adapt. Blind to the facts of what you don't understand. Blind to the facts by the media scams. Blind to the facts of what you read in the book. Blind to the facts of
Download your copy today of Mr. Zero Tolerance from www.cdbaby.com or go to www.cdbaby.com/cd/besick2. Download your copy today. Keep the realness in the rap game.
Yee! What up, though? It's the undeniable J.T. Money, a.k.a. the Bitchizer, and you tuned in to STEM Radio with Maxwell Silverhammer and G.J. the Jerk Man. Heavy that. And guess what? They hate hoes almost as much as I do. So don't sleep on these cats. And speaking of sleeping, don't forget to check out my new single, Hustlin', from my new project, Morning Wood. It's going down heavy, baby. And speaking of being out, I'm out like a busted traffic, like you already know. Get him, Jay!
We think it's the banning of...
We are anonymous. And if you don't know, you better ask somebody. My boy Maxwell Silverhammer and my bottom bitch jerk man will set you straight with some good all true shit and none of the shit that irks me. Hey Maxi baby, I still got them videos. You fill my serial port perfectly. Bitch.
Back to the STEM Radio Show, where the man behind the mic only has 20 more minutes to rant about his favorite things, Maxwell Silverhammer.
Oh, only 20 more minutes.
This time has just flown. I can't believe it goes that fast.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. So we were on swallow dicks. I'm sorry, politics. You know, they kind of rhyme. So
what I'm going to do is when I'm home and time is dragging, I'm going to get my car and drive over here.
That's what you do. We'll keep it exciting for you.
It'll go real fast.
We will keep it exciting for you. So we were, we were kind of on this. Well, we were on this whole political thing. We were talking about
RTC. Yeah, buses.
Well, we were on Obama.
No, we were talking about transportation and
that was a little
mass transit and traffic.
Well, then we got on Obama, and then we got on the political system, and I was saying that unfortunately, the two party thing is archaic. And you had started to say that you're right because, but they'll never abolish, they'll never let a third party in. You know, it's going to be two parties, forever, because obviously they're making money. It's money and power.
The only way that could ever happen is if a gigantic portion of the population did that all at once. Registered as an independent or whatever the party they wanted to be.
They
all have to get on the same page at the same time.
Well, then a vote might actually count.
In a large number.
No, that's... I mean, obviously...
Only way it can.
It's just funny, man. As lazy as we are as a country, that we're so willing to just lay back and let everybody, let our government just, shit all over us and take our guns and take our rights and all...
Taking my gun.
Yeah, well, that's what I'm saying. We can't allow that shit.
Somebody's going to get shot.
But there are so many people that are just willing to just take the dick. This is what they do. They just lay back and, and they're just, they're enjoying the government assistance they all get.
I saw, I can't pinpoint this exactly, and I don't know, it was just a couple of weeks ago. I think it was on Facebook, as a matter of fact. Statistics from... all over the world with regards to those countries that have guns and countries that don't. Do you remember seeing anything like that, the statistics?
I know.
And how crime has dissipated since people started getting guns, arming themselves?
Oh, yeah, well, yeah. Well, what about England? I mean, I've heard different stuff. It's twisted.
The cops aren't even allowed to have guns in England.
Well, I know. But it's very, it's skewed based on... the person who gives the statistic. This is the problem with statistics and shit, is everybody tells you...
Well, I think that Obama opened his mouth up and said we were the third, or we were the highest, how the hell did he put it? There are more shootings in this country than any other nation, and we were like sixth or seventh.
And that's something he would say, obviously to scare you, Never mind, he makes
up... But, if you take the guns, I keep saying this, and it's really... common sense. If he comes and confiscates all the guns from all of us, who's going to have all the guns?
Them.
The criminals.
The criminal, right, because the guns they get are illegal.
They get all the guns they want whenever they want to get them.
How about that one guy? Did you hear about him? Yee? Senator Yee, who is a fucking a gun trafficker? You know, he's trying to take guns away from everybody, but that's what he does. He's a gun dealer. He
takes them away from everybody and sells them to somebody else?
Yep, exactly. So, you know.
Yeah, take our guns, and then the criminals will own. They're the only ones who have guns. We're going
to sell them to criminals, so that way
The criminals and the cops.
Yeah, criminals, and, you know, maybe they're going to work for the government. I don't know.
And I don't even know about the cops anymore. He wants to federalize all the police forces. So.
Oh, God.
You know.
This is
unbelievable
great.
What this guy has done.
And then, you know, what if...
And gotten away with.
What if Billary decides to take over, you know, after he's done?
You know, I can't see her. I mean, taking over. I just can't see it. But it could happen.
Well, exactly. You'd think that people would say, all right, enough fun. Enough of this shit. But...
Well, I ran. All my signs one time said, enough is enough. You think it helped? No.
No. People didn't care.
They didn't care that enough was enough.
Yeah, they like I said, as long as it's there's, you know, you're getting free Obama phones and you're getting, right. You know, government assistance.
And there's a very, it's not 20 people. It's a gigantic portion of the population.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know,
they find they can make more money from the government than they can if they go to work.
Well, there you go. Well, that's it. It's a win-win situation. The government gets they control you, and you as a citizen, like you just said, make more money collecting a government check. And then, don't let people start claiming that, you know, drug and alcohol abuse is a disease. You know, oh, I got a disease now. I can't work. I'm 100% disabled.
Liberalism is the only disease that I validate any longer.
It's socialism. It's the socialist mindset, man. You know, where we're gonna take your money. We're gonna take your guns. We're gonna take this. We're gonna have control. You know, that's what they want to do too now. You know, yep. Put the chip in you. You know, in your finger, so you can.
Well, before they take the country over, they've got to get all the guns out of the hands of people. That'll never happen.
Have fun with that one.
That'll never happen.
Because especially, you know, there's more of us than there are of Congress. You know, so we'll see what. This is what they do. It's a control thing. You know, so they can get don't tell me you're jumping on Facebook again. I can tell. You kind of lean back, like, oh, let me check my Facebook. See, somebody's getting buzzed already. So, but no, people are getting very, and I get the shit. And unfortunately, I got to say this. You know, I'm not a fan of either party, but at least I can say for conservatives, they at least respect your opinion. And at least they show who they really are. Liberals will lie about who the fuck they are. And then if you voice your opinion, they want to shut you down and they want to, you know, attack you and call you names. And, you know, trust me, I know from arguments I've had on Facebook and with people in general.
The thing that bothers me, I go along with what you're saying, but the additional thing that bothers me is the fact that when they present their arguments, they're not factual.
No, it's stuff that's pulled from whatever.
Exactly.
You know, I don't even know where they get their statistics in a lot of cases.
But the statistics they use are all manufactured.
Yeah, I'm sure. And I'm sure there's some website you can go to get, you know.
Manufactured statistics.
Skewed statistics and and things like that. You know, let me just see something here. My brother did text me back. Oh, okay. It's at the, remember the blue card thing I was telling you about? The blue card where they're going to shred the blue cards.
On, are you talking on the phone?
No, actually, I'm talking to you all, but I'm reading a text at the same time. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6,
you're
7.
Reading it. How do you do that?
And we're going to show you.
Okay.
New Frontier Armory.
The New Frontier Armory is where this. So it's going to be on July 18th, Saturday, July 18th, from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m., and it's going to be at the New Frontier Armory. So that's where they're going to shred the blue cards. So if you're interested, anybody's interested, they can go down there. So,
I'm going to ask a cop tomorrow about that. I'm really interested. That doesn't make any sense.
I'm curious. Well, I'm wondering if this is more gun fear shit.
How do they know that it's your gun? That's the question.
Well, and maybe they're waiting for mass fucking hysteria. So they go, oh, you know, you guys want to throw away the blue cards, and look what it did, you see? You know, it's almost like they want to... it's like a let them eat cake thing.
The interesting thing is that Metro was all for it.
Well, again, maybe it's a let them eat cake thing. You know, like, okay, fine. Here, we'll give you what you want just to watch it blow up in your face. You know what I'm saying? So
they didn't oppose that bill up there in Carson.
Oh, I'm sure they didn't, because like I said, I'm sure they want an excuse.
Well, it's a lot of less work for them.
Well, or they want an excuse to take the guns. This is kind of what they want. Because this is just one more thing to go, see, you crazy gun fucking, you know, wackos. You wanted the blue cards destroyed. Now, how do we trace guns when crimes have been committed with stolen guns? We can't do that. So you see how your thing doesn't work? We got to protect you against yourselves. So we're going to take your gun away. It's that kind of bullshit. It's almost like I said, it's the, you know, let you.
I don't quite understand the thing with the background checks. Why is there such an uproar over the background checks? Why don't people want background?
You know, and I guess you could say in one hand, well, I don't have nothing to hide. But then another thing is like, well, who the fuck are you to get into my business? But, you know.
Well, in my bill, when I first drafted it, the biggest thing that I was concerned about was morons getting their hands on a gun.
Right.
So there was a portion in there that never was addressed before, and that was whether you had a prehistory of domestic violence or drug or alcohol.
Right.
Let alone the criminal, you know.
Right,
so exactly. They had a sign, a thing saying that somebody could delve into their private life.
Right. Right.
Is that what's being opposed? I don't know.
Well, I mean, and this is the thing. They cloud these issues so we can't make an educated decision.
But I don't have a problem with the background check. I don't know why everybody's in an uproar over it.
I don't have a problem. I mean, me, myself, I don't have anything on my record, you know, so
But
I'm
aren't
clean.
You concerned about Joe Schmuck down the street?
That's who
being a 12-time loser, and he's going to get a gun.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So,
no,
I don't understand it. Do you understand what the problem is with it?
No, I believe that a background check should be done. I mean, if you're getting a firearm.
But a thorough background check.
Yeah, I mean, if you're getting a firearm that could possibly kill somebody, you should have a background check. I think people should be allowed to carry guns, but I think they should be checked to see if they can carry a gun.
Right.
If any kind of mental history, anything like that should be questionable.
You know, I'm sure you gentlemen know this, but back in the 1800s, there was a law that was in the state, and it's called open carry. That law exists today. You don't need to go get a background check or anything. Strap a gun on and go down the street.
That's all you can do.
The only problem is Metro's going to hassle the shit out of you.
Right.
So, but it's not against the law.
So they can't take your gun, right? If you're just walking around with the gun on your waist?
Did you read the story? Was it AK? Guy had an AK-47. He was around the street.
Yeah, oh, shit. Yeah,
and they stopped him, and they were real nice. What are you doing? He said, I just want to walk around with the gun.
And he walked around with it. There was nothing they could
do.
They could do.
So they'll fuck with you and maybe even threaten you a little bit, but, you know, there's really nothing.
If you know the laws and know your rights, there's nothing that they can honestly do.
Well, and that's the problem.
And
though.
I think it's on YouTube. It was maybe 20, 30-minute video about this guy arguing with the cops.
Yeah, I watched it. Yeah.
He kept saying, well, arrest me. Yeah, arrest me.
Have I done anything illegal? They're like, no, you have not.
Amazing.
I just don't understand the uproar about the background checks. I don't know why everybody's.
Yeah, you're right. That's a little over the top. Because you're right. I mean, I would rather, you know, have, you know, people that are intelligent or that aren't crazy, you know, having guns, because then this way, yeah. But this is, like I said, I think the reason they're doing this, the card shred thing, I just came to this conclusion as we're talking about it, is it's a let them eat cake thing. They want to see us, pardon the pun, shoot ourselves in the foot. Because now it's like, okay, see, you gun nuts, look what happened now. You know, we shredded the blue cards. Nobody can trace those guns.
Well, see, the biggest thing is that does happen. I mean, it's not going to be a law-abiding citizen that actually carries a gun that really cares about it. There was some wacko come out and do it, and that's where the point all this stuff. Like we had down in Carolina there, you know, this is a wacko that just popped out of nowhere.
Well,
now we need to take everybody's guns away. Well, if we do background checks, we find out these things, of course you're going to have Fruit Loops that pop out of the system once
in a while. Out of the room, I was just telling him, take every gun from every legal person that has a gun, and the only people will have are cops
illegals.
And criminals.
Yeah, because they're not waiting for the law to say, oh, well, nope. I don't want to break the law. They're criminals. They don't give a damn.
Yeah, so what?
The other thing I don't understand is why background checks aren't done on people that buy guns at gun shows. Mm-hmm. And also, if I was to sell him a gun, I'm not required to do a background check.
Right.
I just sell him
the
gun.
Sell it to him.
Yeah. Just a straight up sale.
So that's a problem in my opinion. Mm-hmm. You know.
Yeah. No, it is. You're right. But there's too many loopholes, and that's it. That's what they're hoping for. you know, that we, you know, make ourselves look stupid and do some dumb shit, you know, that obviously, you know, it's something that's going to come back and bite us in the ass later. That, oh, okay, well, hey, we allowed you to have a gun, you know.
Well, they can do that now if they really wanted. There's still plenty of citizens that carry guns. I mean, if that's really what they wanted to do, it could be done simply right now.
Right.
I mean, they don't want to have to wrestle the gun out of your hand. They want people to convince you shouldn't have a gun in your hand.
Well, yeah, I mean, look at Sandy Hook, that wasn't real.
Exactly right. I mean, they've done a lot of, I mean, even the FBI came out and announced that they didn't find any true deaths there that day.
No, how can the school's closed.
You know, and I don't know if you've seen any of the YouTube videos where the parents that were supposed to be the ones of the shot children that were sitting there, and they were laughing and giggling, and they're like, okay, we're ready to go live, and they go, okay, hang on a second, and they start getting into character and like, oh, my son, and like, okay, why would you be laughing and giggling? And then all of a sudden, but these, they do a lot of these, they hire character actors, bottom line. The government's known for doing that. They've done it for years and continue to do that, and they, these are people that are just supposed to be out there to do these little play acting things that they're supposed to be training the military with, or police departments. And a lot of it is just, they actually use it as false flags later on to say, hey, look, this is what's truly going on. Yeah. Now this is what we need to do to make this country a little bit better.
Right.
We're taking your guns away and a lot of other things.
And it's in the name of your safety.
But right, and that's the whole thing. They don't want to be the ones wrestling out of your arms.
You know, realize back in the old West, everybody had a gun.
Everybody carried
a gun.
Sure.
Everybody had a gun.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Yeah, well, and but this is something they want to see. Like we said, with the no background checks, with the shredding the cards, and nobody can trace the guns now. So now they want us to have some major crimes. They can say, see, you people can't, you know, you don't understand how it works. We see the bigger picture. Trust me, I know how the motherfuckers
work. The first real gun grab that they had was actually Katrina when the hurricane went through.
Oh, and people were looting and shit?
No, they really weren't looting at the time. The government took FEMA set back for, I think, 3 months before they truly started to do anything. Then when they did go in, they said that the situation was so bad they had to go gun grabbing because they were afraid that people were going to start shooting each other up. It really, truly didn't happen, but they did do a lot of gun grabbing at that.
You know, I just happened to think about the registration thing. The reason, I think, and I don't know for sure, the rationale is that if they take the blue cards and people are going to get guns, they're going to want to carry them, they're going to have to get a concealed weapons permit.
Uh-huh.
And that gun and the serial number is on that permit.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. All right. So
maybe that's it. I'm going to ask a cop tomorrow.
All right. But what if you just have a gun at home? You don't want to carry it around necessarily. You have it at your house, you know, in your drawer or something. Then what? Or somebody breaks in and steals that gun.
Well, then we're back to square one.
Right. Exactly. So that's that. You know, ask the cop and let me know.
Yeah, you better hope your fingerprints aren't on that gun that's stolen and shoot somebody.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
You know, we find your fingerprints on the gun. Yeah. I mean, there's a lot of room for error now. So that's why I think this is something that's set up.
You think it's a flat-out setup?
I think it's a setup.
Well, you think maybe it's a setup to, if we don't want to willingly give up our guns later on, do the false flags to make it believe that they have to do the gun grabs and make it legal at that point?
Look how bad it's gotten. It's out of control.
Could be.
You can't, you know, nobody knows whose guns are registered to who. And, you know, now you've taken away the blue card, so, you know, it's too dangerous for you people. We need to step in and save you from yourselves. So, you know how they do it.
I don't think that they'll ever be able to control it 100%. Mm-hmm. The guy that killed everybody in the church, it was the father's gun. He bought the gun and gave it to the son.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The son never went. If he had ever gone through a background check, he would have
never gotten one.
Right. Yeah, he's a former, you know, felon.
Right. Yeah.
So the dad bought the gun, and it was a gift. It was like,
it was a gift, a birthday present.
And you know, here's the
Happy
other
birthday.
Thing. They turned this into a. That was another one they tried to make racially motivated. I think it was just some crazy.
Well, think about it. There's a two
for
one right
thing.
There.
If I want to give my gun a present, my son a present, I buy the gun.
Mm-hmm.
They do the background check on me.
Right.
Okay. I just give him the gun.
Hmm.
Hmm. Well, and he does what he does.
And he's a drugger, and he goes out and shoots 50 people.
But that was a twofer right there, because first of all, we had a gun issue now that to say, hey, look, we shouldn't be carrying guns anymore, and also a racial issue going on.
Yep.
It was a white guy that went into a black church and shot up a bunch of people and killed them.
And never mind, you know, this guy's probably just completely fucking crazy. He could have gone into any church.
I have a little problem with that, the white guy going in and killing the black people. Mm-hmm. That was not the right thing to do, obviously.
Yeah.
Whenever a black guy kills somebody, you never read or hear about it.
Well, there's a lot of stuff that goes on with that nowadays. Yeah. And
remember the black guy that killed the cops?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
There was two lines in the paper, and you never heard another word.
Well, that's because if you and I'm not being racist here in any way, shape, or form, but if you have a Japanese that stands up and said, I'm proud of my race, you have a black that stands up, a black power, I'm proud of my race. Any race can stand up and say they're proud of their race, except for the white race. If we stand up and say we're proud, we're instantly racist, and I don't understand that kind of thought.
I don't either.
And now there's all this talk.
I mean, black people can say the N-word all they want to, and it's right. It's the right thing to do.
We talked about
that.
But
we can't say the
N-word. Oh, yeah, we always talk about that.
No, and it's ridiculous. I mean, if you don't want that word used, then don't use it yourself.
Don't use it at all. Yeah.
I mean, abolish the thing and get rid of it entirely. It's not that hard to do.
I mean, listen to some of these rap music, and N-word's all through the damn thing.
Oh, yeah, that's what we've talked about a lot of times. We're like,
But that's not racist.
Yeah, but no, because they own the word now, they say. Well, that's bullshit.
Yeah, how do you own a word?
Yeah. That's like saying, you know, I had the measles
white
once.
White people owned the word and gave it to them.
Yeah.
Hey, well,
it's like saying I had measles once, so I own all measles around the planet. Just ridiculous. Yeah, Why would I want to own something like that?
It's like white privilege, same shit. Anyway, Lou, thank you for coming in, spending some time with us.
We're not done yet, are we?
We are done. We're out of here.
Kidding.
We are out of here. I'm Maxwell Silverhammer.
Fastest 2 hours I've ever spent. Honestly, that it was. Really, I couldn't believe it.
I'm GJ, proud of my race, Jerkman.
And that's the story there, bitches. See ya. Radio speak. Radio speak. Radio speak.